What's up? My name is Elsa. Welcome to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. We've been here plenty of times before, and today we are continuing our journey for Persona 4 Golden. This is part 7. You're probably going to see this twice in the next two videos because I didn't record an intro. In part 6, we were able to save Naoto. Sorry for like the chopped and screwed version of that. It was so long of context and talking that I just have to chop it up if I want to get through this game and if I want to get you guys into our next journey as of like maybe 2 weeks from now, hopefully. We'll see. But yeah, we saved Naoto the last time. We're really building up a lot of our relationships. Like, subscribe, all that jazz, and let's get into it.
Whoa, it's freezing.
Why are we getting together on the roof on a day like this?
Yeah, what's this urgent business about, Yosuke-senpai?
Seriously, I was busy handing out flyers at Juness.
Hey, I saw you hitting on girls just outside the school gate.
Was there some kind of progress in the case?
I need you guys. You have to help me. You're the only ones I can rely on. Can you please keep this weekend open?
This weekend? Does this have anything to do with that event at the Inaba police station that's been canceled?
What are you talking about?
The idol Kanami Mashita was scheduled to be the honorary chief this Sunday.
Oh my gosh! The famous Kanamin is...
So she's taking on jobs like that already.
I have been seeing a lot of her on TV lately. I didn't know she belonged to the same agency as you, Rise-chan.
I mean, if she's coming to Inaba now, the agency's obviously trying to use all the fuss about me to their favor.
So what's the big deal about that being canceled, Yosuke-senpai?
There was going to be a big sale at Juness to take advantage of the event, but now it's down the tubes!
It's not a joke! The police took forever to decide on canceling the event. My dad's really in a fix now. He worked so hard to put this whole thing together, and I can't stand to see him like this. I can't just let it go.
I heard that the police couldn't prepare for the event because I had gone missing. I'm sorry. This is my fault.
No, it's not your fault. Don't blame yourself. But yeah, it does seem like that's what happened.
Okay, so you called us up here. What do you want us to do about it?
From the way it sounds, I gotta say, I don't think we can be much help.
I want everyone to help me with a bunch of different tasks.
Rise-san, well, if you could, you know, do an event at Juness.
You want me to substitute for Kanami?
So there's no way?
Is it really that bad?
I don't know. I may be his son, but I'm still only a part-timer. But my dad's being awfully nice for some reason. I think it's possible that he might get fired if this thing falls through. If that happens, I might have to transfer schools again. Seriously, what am I gonna do if that happens?
Singing and handshakes only. No autographs and nothing that I can't do as a high school student. Otherwise, I'll get in trouble. And I'll only do it if you all get on stage with me.
What? Wait! I'm no idol!
It would be troublesome if people came to try to recruit me to be an idol.
Me too! I already have an exclusive contract with Juness.
I think you guys are worrying about the right things here. But if you're gonna sing, what are we supposed to do on stage?
I need a band, of course. I'll make this very clear. I can't use pre-recorded tracks.
Whoa, there's no way we can pull off something like that!
I have some experience playing the keyboard. My grandfather suggested that I take piano lessons when I was younger. I have one that I can bring as well.
You're up for this?
This incident is a result of my actions, after all. I will do whatever I can to help.
Naoto, thanks. If it's music you need, I have a guitar. Never really played it, though. Oh, wait, I accidentally bought a bass once. I think it's in storage.
How do you accidentally buy something like that? I bet you just thought it was another guitar.
I should have some kind of musical instrument at my place, for dinner parties and such.
Some kind of instrument? Oh boy.
Then it's decided! I'll look for a song I can sing that can use a band arrangement. You guys get instruments and find a place to practice!
Got it. Try to pick an easy one, okay? Alright, now now that this is happening, I'm getting fired up about it.
Let's go ask if we...
So, what are we gonna do with these? I just grabbed whatever I could find that wasn't being used by the symphonic band.
What is that?
It's a gong.
Well, duh. I'm pretty sure he meant to ask, what is that doing here?
I thought Chie might want to play that. You know, it sounds kind of Chinese-ish.
I don't think that's gonna really matter in this case.
Yosuke, try holding these!
Huh?
I see.
Yeah, you do look like that when you're fighting. Try summoning your persona while you're holding those.
All right. Persona! Wait, I can't summon it here.
I'll choose this then.
Look! Isn't this like my fan?
I think she's convinced we're playing for a dinner party at the inn.
Come on, we need stuff like guitars instead of little backup instruments like these. Hey, I'll play the guitar. Why don't you take the bass? I can at least teach you a little bit. Wait, do you already know how to play the bass? Because that would be awesome! Actually, I know next to nothing about it. Way to step up, partner.
Well then, since you two and Natsu-kun have decided what to play, let's put Kanji on drums.
Hey, why don't I get to pick?
If you're up front, it'll look like a metal band.
I think you'd be good at the drums. You're always hitting and stomping on things, after all.
Does that make any sense?
Then I will take over all the charming percussion. Hey, baby, I'll lay down the passionate beats that flow from my soul.
So that leaves Yukiko and me?
You two. How about the chorus? There is a part for that.
Singing?
No can do. We'll hold something. Let's see. What looks easy?
Are we really going to manage this? I'm starting to get the feeling that it's impossible no matter what we do.
There's just not enough time.
Sensei, I want to play in a... If it's over, then it's over for Yosuke, too. That means it's over for me. And I can't bear to face that.
I don't want to know that you're only doing this because you're selfish. But you've got a point. If we give up, it all ends there.
That's right. Everything would have been for nothing if we give up now. Real brawl doesn't begin until you got your back to a wall.
We're not talking about a brawl here.
I'll do it too. It's not just about Yosuke now. I'll simply feel angry at myself if I give up.
Don't worry, Yosuke-senpai. I agreed to do this, so I'll do it. I didn't say anything pathetic like, I'll do what I can. I'm going to get a huge crowd, no matter what. And they will go home satisfied. Please, I just need your help to do it.
Wow. Now that's how a pro delivers a team-boosting speech.
Well then, should we resume our practice?
All right, let's do this!
I did it! I did it! So this isn't broken after all!
Crap! The crowd's a lot bigger than I expected!
Don't say stuff like that! You're making me even more nervous!
Our costumes okay? I mean, they're just our normal school uniforms. Even worse are the winter ones.
What else could we have done? It's not like we have any costumes. The clothes we've been wearing all summer won't work as costumes, and since we'll be changing wardrobes tomorrow, it works out.
Oh, crap. I can't stop my legs from shaking.
You'll be hitting the skins more than a bare-knuckle boxer!
You shut your stupid bear trap! I don't need to hear this!
You've been on TV before, right, Naoto-kun? Aren't you used to this? You haven't said a word.
The last time I played for a crowd was a piano recital when I was young. Doing an interview on TV is much easier. Even if I make a mistake, I'm the only one who gets embarrassed by it.
You're saying doing interviews is easy? That's crazy, too. Oh, I can't take this much longer. Don't you get nervous too? Wait, you are? Sensei's face is like a waterfall! What are we supposed to do? Huh? Did someone just...
Everyone, can you gather around for a second?
Yeah, got it.
They're asking for an encore.
Oh, yeah. I didn't think about that.
We only know one song! What do we do now?
There are only two things we can do. Ignore them and leave, or play the same song over again.
Maybe we can have Rise explain our situation and they'll go easy on us and let us replay that song. I saw that guy before.
Teddy?
Yeah! Crowd surf! This is the best part of being a live performer!
Stupid Teddy! We can't play without him!
Hey, hey! Why don't we all dive into the crowd? They might just carry us out of here and we can escape this awkward situation!
Stage dive? Hey, don't sound so excited! Actually, if all seven of us jump in, there'd be trouble.
Then what are we gonna do? Do we have any other way out?
If you want to do it that much, then just the guys do it!
All right! I'll show you what it means to be a man!
They just dodged out of the way. How?
I didn't know it was possible to stand on your own face.
I'm home.
Oh, welcome back.
There was a letter in the mailbox for you.
Is it from a friend? Oh, my show is almost done.
I'll protect you all from the madness of this world. I'll take you to a place where you can be at peace. Yes, it's much more peaceful than here.
Don't rescue anymore. Is this a warning?
No punctuation or capitalization. Aw, what a cliche.
Ain't this just a prank? The kind of stuff that only happens in the movies?
Did you show this to your uncle?
Senpai, Dojima-san is trustworthy. But it may be best to keep this to ourselves. He will ask why you received such a letter, and if he were to put you under surveillance, our hands would be tied. If this letter is real, what's most important isn't what it says. It's the fact that it was delivered to the Dojima residence, addressed directly to you. This means the culprit knows in great detail who has been interfering with his crimes. And of all of us, he chose to deliver his message to the Dojima residence, home of a police detective. I'd have this letter checked at a crime lab if I could, but even then I doubt they'd find anything. The text is a warning, while the subtext expresses the culprit's confidence that we can't use it to pinpoint his identity.
So it's useless to tell the police. In fact, that would make things worse.
Cross your fingers, it's just a prank.
I think the chances of that are slim. This message is too specific, too perfect to be a prank. But how could the killer know so much about us? Could he be watching us from somewhere?
Teddy's been saying for a while that when we're over there, he senses someone watching us. Wait. Every time we went to the other side to rescue someone, did we end up on the Midnight Channel ourselves?
I don't know. It seems like no one else knows what we're doing. I haven't heard any rumors about us at school. Even the people who I know check that channel haven't said anything. The only gossip I heard was about the people who disappeared.
I see. Come to think of it, how the Midnight Channel works is still a mystery.
Let's put aside for now the matter of what that world truly is. There's too little data to go on. For now, we need to keep in mind that the culprit knows who we are. As long as we're all aware of that, it will be enough for now.
Yeah, guess there's no use thinking about stuff we can't understand. Freaking out over speculation is just what the killer wants us to do, right?
Yeah. Mind if I change the subject then? The culture festival's just around the corner. What's our class doing again?
Oh yeah, it hasn't been decided yet, huh?
I heard we'll be voting on it soon. But aren't they still gathering ideas?
Whoa, I think Yosuke just got hit with a bolt of inspiration. Whatever it is, it'll be out there. I'd bet my lunch on it.
Hey, Senpai. Have you decided who you'll be going around the campus with during the festival?
My schedule's still wide open, you lucky guy. Oh, she just had to say something.
Well... Was it you, Chie?
Yeah, right. Why would I do such a thing?
What's a group date cafe?
Who knows? But I doubt anyone will vote for it.
Yeah, it's just a joke idea. You gotta have one weird one mixed in, you know?
Ah, figures!
We'll be passing around the vote sheet. Just circle one of the suggestions.
All right, time to count the votes. The first vote is... group date cafe. Second vote, group date cafe. Huh? Seriously? Third vote, video room. Fourth vote, group date cafe. Group date cafe, group date cafe, study room, group date cafe.
Well, first place? What are we gonna do?
Wonder though, do all those people who voted for it realize they have to run it themselves?
I've never been on a group date before, so I was a little curious.
What the? You voted for it?
Yeah, I thought it would be sad if no one voted for it.
But Yosuke's the one behind it!
Hey, it wasn't just me, it came in first place! The public agrees!
Well, since the majority rules, we'll be doing the group date cafe. But what does that even mean? Is it like speed dating? Can we really pull this off? You'd all better pitch in on this.
Actually, would the teachers be okay with this?
Dude, how could Kashiwagi say no?
Miss Kashiwagi's busy getting ready for those two notorious pageants. That's why she's leaving it up to us students to decide what to do.
Yeah, right. She just dumped it in our laps because she didn't want to bother.
Group date cafe? Are we gonna get any customers with this?
Seriously, what is a group date cafe? I voted for it and I didn't even know. Oh my gosh. How the heck's this gonna turn out? On top of planning it, Kashiwagi's gonna be in it?
So that's why she agreed to plan this event.
One, two... Wow, there's a lot of signups here. I'm surprised so many people took an interest.
Whoa, Risei Kuchikawa? Seriously?
Oh man, trust a celebrity to kill the fun of it all. I bet she'll draw a huge crowd.
Wow, Yukiko-san's finally entering. If this was any other year, she'd win for sure. Now she's up against Rosette. It's gonna be a culture festival to remember.
Huh? Rosette's entering? She's gonna take part? Maybe I better think more seriously about saving a seat.
Look, Chie's entering too. She's actually pretty close to my type.
Actually, I hear she has a lot of secret admirers.
Naoto's that boyish, girlish, whatever, right? You know, she's, pretty cute.
Dude, you sound like a pervo when you laugh like that. But, to be honest, I think she's cute too.
Are you free for lunch? I don't know why, but Chie asked us to come to the roof. She looked pretty... Oh, and Kanji's coming too.
Hey, it's Yosuke. We're expecting great things from you.
They're doing the cross-dressing pageant again this year? Man, they never learn, do they? Ooh, some people have signed up already. Man, what idiots would want to be in this thing? Let's see, Yosuke Hanamura...
Me?!
Wait, and Kanji Tatsumi?
You're on here too!
There's a lot of contestants. Didn't we only get, like, two people last year?
I heard this year, even if someone else signs you up, you can't back out.
Well, that's not cool. Hey, but what if they did sign themselves up?
Ew, what a disturbing thought! Seriously, that's really wrong.
Someone else signs you up? It's them. They must have done this.
Come in for a first-hand experience with group dating.
Oh, this is so embarrassing. There's not that many people passing by here in the first place.
I think we need some shills to drum up interest.
Shills? Who?
Who else is here besides us?
Isn't that kind of sad?
Do we have a choice? We need customers to get the ball rolling. If there aren't many people passing by, we have to get the attention of the ones who are by any means necessary.
But there's only five of us here.
Yo, how's it going? I came to check up on you... guys?
Perfect timing!
But now we've got four guys and two girls.
Eh, you guys are cross-dressing tomorrow anyways. One of you can sit on the girls' side.
What? I'm not gonna...
You're volunteering?
You never run out of surprises, man.
Well, let's get started. You guys can start now.
Man, he's really getting into this.
Actually, what the hell is this?
A mock group date.
Should I lead off?
I guess I'd like a cute girl. Well, for me, I guess a girl that's kind and sort of fragile, you know? Someone I'd want to protect. Man, this is, yeah. Hey, your turn, Kanji.
I guess someone who's kind of mysterious and, looks strong, but's actually kinda...
Yeah, I really wonder who you're talking about.
Okay, out of the three of us here, who would you date?
Hey, I object to this line of questioning.
Oh, don't worry. All right, let's start with you, Chie-san.
Huh? Wait, well?
Me? Who would I choose to date? Well, that's private. Okay, your turn. Who would you want to date?
Phew, what a relief.
Oh. Senpai, how are you doing?
Mark it. The group date cafe is officially a failure.
So it begins.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now begin the second day of the Culture Festival with the ever-popular Miss Yasogami Pageant. Let's get right down to it and introduce our first contestant. She's a runaway express train who's Inaba born and bred and can kill with both her fists and her looks. Presenting Kanji-chan of the first year, Class 3!
Sup?
Ew, that's so creepy!
Oh, this is wrong on every level!
Now, don't rip me apart for asking, but what would you say is your best feature?
My eyes?
Conventional answer from this all-too-unconventional beauty! After such a strong start, I don't know how much of a chance the others have, but here's our second contestant! An eloquent heiress of the noble Juness, she's pure disappointment from the moment she opens her mouth. Presenting Yosuke-chan of the second year Class 2!
I thought Yosuke-senpai would be able to pull it off.
Dude, it's terrifying. I can just imagine someone like him sitting across from me on a train.
Now, you look ready to win in that outfit. Do you often dress like this?
Hell no! Like, no way!
What is with this? The laughing stock's up here.
What did you think this was about?
I've already had about enough of this, but there's still more to come. Up next, our third... mildly bitter tang of the city, and she's made more girls cry than there are stars in the sky. Presenting our transfer student who's been breaking hearts in this second year, Class 2!
Cooler than that.
Sounds like your entrance is causing quite a stir. Did you sign yourself up?
Hey, now's not the time to reveal stuff like that. Damn that Kashiwagi. How dare she tear away our innocence like this? Now I'm scarred for life, damn it!
Our last contestant is a random, unaffiliated entrant. She's a friend of our other beauties. Calling herself King of the TV World, she's a cute, sexy little number. Give a warm welcome to Teddy-chan!
Give me your heart.
That's a boy? He's so cute.
I'd hit it.
And the winner of this year's Miss Yasogami pageant is the random contestant who won everyone's heart, Miss Teddy! As our champion, Miss Teddy will receive a very special prize. Later this afternoon, we will be hosting the Miss Yasogami pageant with actual beauties this time. Your reward is a position as an honorary judge in that pageant.
Woohoo! An honorary judge? That's one lame prize for what you gotta go through.
Not everyone can get that excited over a judge position.
Seeing him so happy kind of makes me happy, too.
Yeah, he's like over-the-top innocent.
Well then, Miss Teddy, how does it feel to have won the pageant and become a judge?
The long-awaited day has finally come! I decree that one of the judging criteria later this afternoon will be... Ta-da! A swimsuit competition!
That bear needs to be disappeared. Well, I doubt he has the authority to declare that unilaterally.
This is great. I love the direction this is going.
Dad's late. Did he forget his keys? It was the delivery man. He was asking where Mr. Takahashi's house is. Hello, this is the Dojima residence. Oh, hi, Dad! Uh-huh. All right. It's okay. I know it's your job. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Big Bro's with me, so... Okay. Bye. Dad says he's coming home tomorrow. But I'm not lonely. You're here with me. It's cold today, too. Wanna bring out the kotatsu? Dad said we could pull it out if it gets too cold. That'll make it nice and warm.
Thank you.
was too blurry to jump to any conclusions. But maybe someone has an idea of who it might be. We definitely need to talk. Just remember to keep your schedule open tomorrow after school.
Hey, I'm back.
Welcome back. Dad, the Kotatsu's broken. Can me and Big Bro go buy a new one?
The Kotatsu? Oh, it's already that season, huh? Yeah, the weather has been odd lately. All right, I'll leave it up to you. Get whichever kind you want.
Is that a letter?
It's for you.
Hey, what the hell is this?
Not often we get letters with no return address on them. So, I was right. Be straight with me. You're involved in the case, aren't you? What are you up to? So you're not gonna be honest with me. I've been treating you like family. But I see that was a mistake. I should have intervened much earlier because I care for you. I will have the truth from you today.
Dad?
We'll continue this somewhere else. But I'm not letting you leave until I'm convinced. This is for your own good, got that? It's all right, we're not fighting. We'll be right back, so don't wait up for us to get to bed, okay?
Okay, I'll be waiting.
I'll hold on to this. Now speak up. What have you gotten yourself into? What was that warning letter about? Why would you be sent something like that? Persona? People going inside a TV? I thought you'd finally tell me what's really going on here. Enough! That's enough! I guess half a year wasn't long enough for you to trust me like your old man. But I'd hoped you'd open up to me a little. It's a shame. Stay here for the night.
Whoa, sorry. Dang, go inside TVs and personas, huh? Well, you can't blame him. I mean, sure, I want to believe you. And I know Dojima-san brought you here and asked you those questions because he wants to believe you too. Plus, you know, you'll be safe here. He probably freaked out once he saw that letter and thought he had to protect you. Like what a father would do for his son. I think he cares for you a lot. So yeah, don't take it so hard. You know, Dojima-san started looking into people involved with the first case again. Guess he wasn't satisfied with the way the case wrapped up after all. That's why he's even more sensitive about this and that. I better shut up now before I get chewed out again. All right, I'll be just outside. If you need anything, let me know.
Y'all, they kidnapped Nanako. We gotta... Nope. Nope.
Hmm? What are you guys doing here?
Hey, what do you think you're doing? I didn't say you could go in there.
Nanako-chan's missing.
What? What do you mean?
Naoto's on the phone, calling from Nanako-chan. I mean, your house.
Shirogane, you there? What the hell's going on?
I'm at your house right now. The front door is open and there's no one inside. I'm afraid that Nanako-chan has been kidnapped by our serial killer. Surely you must have known, Dojima-san. The case isn't over yet.
This is the KJ Customer Service Center. The number you have dialed is unavailable right now. The phone may be switched off or outside our coverage area.
Nanako.
Dojima-san.
Is this true? Has Nanako really been... Why? Why, Nanako?
It's probably because the media...
What are you doing?
Traffic Division, Ota speaking.
There's been a kidnapping. Get your man on it immediately. Start with checkpoints along the highway.
Checkpoints? Could you explain the situation a little more?
Quit griping and get to it! The victim's a 7-year-old girl. My daughter!
Your daughter? Wait, what about the scene? What makes you think this is a kidnapping?
That's... Look, this could be connected to that multiple murder case.
Connected? But we caught the killer. How long has she been missing? Have you received any notices or ransom letters?
No, but damn it, there's no time for this right now.
All right. I'll try contacting each of the departments.
Even if you tell them this is connected to the murders, we can't prove it. And everyone on the force thinks this case is over and done with. Where are you going?
I'm gonna go look for my daughter. If this is connected to that murder case, the top brass won't accept the facts until it's too late. I'm not gonna wait for those clowns.
But do you even have any ideas or leads on who took her? If they used a car, there's no way...
Shut up! That's why I'm hurrying!
What am I gonna do? Dojima-san's run off half-cocked.
Adachi-san, we'll go look for her too. So please, let him go!
Huh? You know I can't.
So what's going on?
Whoa, hey! If I let all you guys in here, then I'm really in trouble. Besides, we don't even know if this thing's...
Quit your bitching! Now ain't the time for that shit! The hell are we sitting here for when this guy's family's in danger? You gonna own up if something happens? Huh?
Kanji-kun!
I know how you feel, but if you don't tell me what's going on, there's really nothing I can do.
So you agree to release him once we explain the situation? Very well, then.
No, that's not what I meant.
In any case, if we run out blindly, we'll have no idea where to begin. Let's all take a moment to stop and sort out the situation. There's no doubt in my mind that this is a kidnapping by the same culprit who was behind the others. Now, consider that the front door at Nanako-chan's house was open. I examined it and found no trace that entry had been forced.
You mean, Nanako-chan opened the door herself?
Precisely. The culprit didn't sneak in. He came boldly up to the front door and pressed the doorbell. Like how it was for all of us.
For all of us?
But the circumstances are different for her as compared to us. Remember what Nanako-chan said when we were at the hot springs? I always do what my dad tells me, like not opening the door for strangers.
So is the killer someone Nana-chan knows?
Senpai, do you have any insight into this possibility? No, I doubt she'd let her guard down for anyone who rarely came to their house. And I'd rule out her classmates. This is beyond the capacity of an elementary school student.
I don't think we can limit ourselves to people Nanako-chan knows.
I agree. Then let us change our perspective slightly. We know for certain that the culprit must be using a large screen TV.
Huh? TV? What?
Each victim was taken at a different scene, yet was thrown into a TV almost immediately after being kidnapped. I would go as far as to say that it took place in front of their houses. Therefore, the culprit must be taking a TV with him as he goes.
You think he's using a car?
Given the efficiency of the culprit's methods, I would assume a vehicle larger than a sedan. However, no unusual vehicles have been sighted. I'd expect someone to notice, since most of the victims vanished during the day.
So it's someone Nanako-chan knows who has a car, but it's a car that can't be seen?
I think we can rule out the possibility that no one happened to see the vehicle, especially since it's happened so many times now.
A car no one would notice? Is there such a thing? What would it be?
That's right. Now I remember. A delivery came. It was a delivery truck!
No one looks twice at a delivery truck, no matter where it's parked.
And if it were a local company, it'd be the same delivery man every time, so he's not a stranger to Nanako-chan. She must have received packages from him during the times she was home alone, meaning we wouldn't know his face. Adachi-san, is there anyone who fits this profile?
A profile formed by a bunch of kids talking it over? Let's see. A delivery company, huh? I don't know. Take it from a detective. I think this is gonna be a lot more difficult than...
Think, Adachi, think. Yes, come on, come on.
Maybe you're not too far off base. Dojima-san put this stuff together to reinvestigate the first case. The murder of that announcer. And there's a delivery man mentioned right here.
I better go tell Dojima-san.
After resigning from his last job, he took up the family delivery business. Before that, he was a council secretary, Taro Namatame.
Who?
The Inca singer's husband.
All we know about him is his occupation, but I'd say that's enough of a lead to tell us where to go next. The address is, it's not far from here.
I give him the clue and he still finds an excuse to chew me out.
Is he gonna be okay? The killer's not just a normal guy.
Nana-chan!
Adachi-san!
If there's been a break in the case, I'd better hurry to the scene. I'll just have to hope nothing happens here while I'm gone. I didn't see any...
Adachi-san.
Let's go to Namatame's place. Dojima-san's probably on his way now.
Is that smoke?
An accident? Oh.
Dojima-san, are you all right?
Where's Nanako?
Hello? We need an ambulance. Quickly, there's been an accident. One adult male is injured.
That's right, I should call backup too. We gotta find Namatame.
Nanako. Where's Nanako?
What happened?
I was on my way to Namatame's house when I saw him drive past me. I gave chase, and he... Damn it. Where's Nanako? And Namatame. Find them. Please.
But how? Yeah, maybe there's clues in the truck.
Wait, you can't! We need to preserve the scene.
Then allow me. If it rains again while we wait, the information we need will be lost regardless.
Look! There really is a TV in there!
Yes, large enough for persons of any size to fit through. I also recovered a diary from the driver's seat, most likely kept by Namatame himself. I learned the existence of a new world, thus I must save people.
Save? The hell's he mean by that?
This... it's a list of the victims' home addresses. Mayumi Yamano, Saki Kanishi, Yukiko Amagi, Kanji Tatsumi, Rise Kujikawa. Even the victims who survived and were never released to the public are written here. I note that Mr. Moraoka's address is absent from the list.
Wow. And that settles it.
The last date is today's. I can't believe such a small child appeared on it. I must save this child no matter what.
Is that about Nanako-chan?
I managed to take her to safety. The police have been active lately.
I feel like there's like a misunderstanding. Because being on that TV, being interviewed is like risky to be killed. But he's not the one doing the killing. He's just putting people in the TV and then like, I don't get it.
This will probably be the last time I write in this diary. I've done everything I can.
It's clear now. He used the same trick on all the victims. He just rang the bell like he was making a normal delivery, then throw the victim into the TV in his truck. Namatame is the killer!
We need to go save Nanako-chan. Here, let's use this TV and...
Wait a sec! We don't know where we'll enter through this one. What if we end up somewhere dangerous? It doesn't seem like it's going to be foggy tomorrow, so we should go in tomorrow, the same way as usual.
But...
if we fail, who's going to save Nanako-chan?
Saving her will be our top priority from tomorrow forward. We'll leave Namatame's whereabouts to the police. Dojima-san.
You guys.
Are you all right?
I almost look like hell right now. Nanako, she's my reason for living. If I lose her, I might as well be dead. She must be so scared right now. Waiting for someone to save her. And here I am. When she needs me most, I'm helpless. What kind of a father am I? I can't even protect my own daughter.
Dojima-san.
If anything happens to Nanako, I'll make Namatame pay. You can save Nanako, right? I trust you. Please, save her for me. You're the only ones I can turn to right now. Please.
We will rescue Nanako-chan at any cost. It may take some time, but you must put your faith in us and wait for us to return with her.
Okay, this is where I'm gonna call it for Persona 4 Golden Part 7. So much has happened, and yeah, so much has happened. In the next one, we are going to save Nanako-chan, because what else can we do? Later.